Hello students, here we are back for the studies of data handling. In the previous session, we have covered the first question of the exercise. I welcome you again to Nagesh Karasbe Orchid School to continue our study of data handling. As we had seen in the previous part, we had covered the different type of graphs that we had studied and what is the difference between them. So, we have seen grouped frequency distribution, we have seen what is class interval, lower limit, upper limit, size of the class interval or which is known as width, then bars with a difference, that is histogram, and after that we had gone to the example. And I had explained you first question of exercise 5.1. Till here we had studied in the previous sessions. Now we shall continue further with the second question of exercise 5.1. You can see there the second question. It says the shoppers who come to a departmental store are marked as man, M, woman, W, boy, B, or girl, G. The following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hour in the morning. The data that is given to us, it is from a departmental store where people have visited. Now they have been categorized. Man, woman, boy or girl. And the list in the first hour in the morning, the people who have visited there, here you can see that WWWGB as on it is going on and at the end it is BGGW. Okay, this is the data. Then what they are asking is, make a frequency distribution table using tally marks. What we have to make? We have to make a frequency distribution table using tally marks and draw a bar graph to illustrate it. What we have to do? We have to draw a bar graph to illustrate it. We shall do one thing, we shall switch to the solution. Now here you can see this is the question. In the solution set, and the frequency distribution table is printed here. You can see in the first column shopper, W for woman, M for men, B for boy and G for girl. So, in the frequency or the number of women who visited is 28, man 15, boy 5 and girl 12, total is 60. So, this is the frequency distribution table. Now, how it has been done? What are the four categories that were given to us? M for man, W for woman, B for boy and G for girl. The same we have written here in the first column. Then we are going to count the number of times W is repeated. Now children, the task is for you to count the number of W's and tally marks. As I had explained you previously, 5 is one group, 4 vertical and 1 across. In this way, 28 is the total number of women who visited the departmental store. Similarly, man 15, boy 5 and girl 12 and the total came to 60. Okay, what is asked? Make a frequency distribution table using tally marks. That is the thing that is here. Next, draw a bar graph to illustrate it. Draw a bar graph to illustrate it. Now we can see the bar graph here. Woman, man, boy, girl. You can see on the x-axis the shoppers are there, and on the y-axis the frequency 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Why till 30? Because maximum number of is of women, it is 28. The frequency shows it is 28. So number of shoppers and shoppers. Women, a bar that is touching 28, man 15, boy 5, and girl it is 12. So in this way you have to draw the bar graph. Proceeding further, let us go for the next question. The weekly wages in rupees of 30 workers in a factory are, what is the data about? The data is about weekly wages in rupees, means the data is about the wages, and that too weekly, of how many persons? Of 30 workers in a factory. You can see the data. 830, 835, 890, 810, it goes on in this way. At the end it is 890, 806, 840. This is the wages of 30 workers in a factory. What they are asking on this data? They are asking us again, what, using tally marks, make a frequency table with intervals 800 to 810, 810 to 820, and so on. They have given us that we have to prepare a frequency table, but they have given the class intervals for us. The class intervals are 800, 810, means it is a difference of, or the width, we can say the width is 10. So 800, 810, 810, 820, we have to see what are the maximum wages that are present here. What is the maximum value? This maximum value, if you can see, it is mostly, I guess it is 898. It is 898. Nobody, we can see here, is getting 900 or something. No, it is 830, 835, and it goes on in this way. 898, if you see on the data properly, if you observe it carefully, you will see that 898 is the maximum value. Let us switch to the solution. And these are the class intervals, 800 to 810, 810 to 820, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, 80 to 90, 890 to 900, means it is from 800 to 900, the class intervals are made of 10 each width. Okay, now let us count. Here the frequency of the workers who are getting the wages between 800 and less than 810, three of them they are. 810 less than 820, two of them they are there. In this way, 830 to less than 840, nine of them they are there. Similarly, at the end I can tell you that 890 to less than 900, yes, it is correct. Why less than 900? Because 898, I have shown you that 898 is the maximum. So four of them they are counted in this. Total frequency is 30. total frequency is 30. So what they had asked? They had asked to make a frequency table using tally marks, and this is the thing that is presented here. We shall go for the next question. What is the next question? Draw a histogram for the following frequency table. What they are saying? Draw a histogram for the following frequency table made for the data in question 3. Means, in other words, whatever just now we have done the frequency table with tally marks in question 3, for the same we have to draw a histogram and answer the following questions. After drawing the histogram, we have to answer the questions. What are those questions? Which group has the maximum number of workers? How many workers earn rupees 850 and more? How many workers earn less than rupees 850? Understand the question properly, children. Here the data is not given. The frequency table that we have prepared for question 3, the same frequency table we are using to draw the histogram. And while doing this, after drawing the histogram, what we have to do? We have to answer the questions that are asked there. Which group has the maximum number of workers? How many workers earn rupees 850 and more? How many workers earn less than rupees 850? Let us switch to the solution. Now, this is the same table which we have to use. Please observe it carefully what we have done. Just now only we have seen it. I hope you have observed it properly. Now, let us go for the histogram. Here you can see the histogram. It is in a dark color. So, it is just on a graph paper. On the x-axis, the wages are present. Before that, between 0 to 800, there is a jagged line, and we have studied in the jagged line that we are not displaying the values from 0 to 800. Why we are not displaying the values from 0 to 800? The reason is very simple, that between 0 to 800, none of the data is present. None of the worker is having wages between 0 to 800. So, there is a jagged line on x-axis. The classes are continuous. For a histogram, the classes need to be continuous. And I hope you have not forgotten, our first question was the same. In our first question, we had studied that on what particular data we can draw a histogram and on what particular data we cannot. On what particular we cannot. Here the classes are continuous, 800 to 810, 810 to 820, 820 to 830, 830 to 840, 840 to 850. In this way, 890 to 900. And whatever the frequencies are there, that frequency is on y-axis. That is number of workers. And on x-axis, the continuous classes are nothing but wages in rupees. The wages are in rupees. So, what we have done, whatever frequency we had here, 3, 2, 1, 9, 5, 1, 3, 1, 1, 4, the same you can see it is here. Maximum is 9, which is 830 to 840. This is 9. After that, 840 to 850, 5 of them. In this way, you can see How many of them? Now we have to answer the questions. What are those questions? How many workers earn ₹850 and more? How many workers earn ₹850 and more? Students, if you remember, we have studied in the starting that if a worker is earning ₹850, he will not be counted in the class interval 840 to 850, but he will be counted in the class 850 to 860. This is the convention that has been taught to us. This is the rule that we have to follow. So, 850 and above, what is our question? Our question is how many workers earn ₹850 and more. So, 850 and more means 1 plus 3, 4, 5, 6 and 4, 10. So, the answer is 10 workers are earning, how many they are? 850 and more. One more question we had, that before that which group has the maximum number of workers? Which group has the maximum number of workers? You can see here the frequency column, 9 is the maximum value. In the frequency column, 9 is the maximum value. So, which class interval it is? 830 to 840. So, what is the answer for that? The answer for that, 830 to 840 group has the maximum number of workers, means maximum number of workers are having the wages between 830 less than 840 it is. And the third question was, how many workers earn less than 850? How many workers earn less than 850? What we have done just now? It was the calculation till here we had added from here. Now, above we have to add 9 plus 5, 14, 14 plus 1, 15, 15 and 2, 17, 17 and 3, 20. Means what is the answer here? 20 workers less, 20 workers earn less than ₹850. So, what are the answers? Maximum number of workers are in the group 830 to 840. 10 workers earn more than ₹850 and 20 workers earn less than ₹850. I hope you people have understood it. Let us go for the next question. The fifth question is, the number of hours for which students of a particular class watch television during holidays is shown through the given graph. What they are saying? They have given a graph below and we have to observe that graph. What that graph is representing? It is presenting number of hours for which students of a particular class watched television during holidays. Answer the following. What are the questions? For how many hours did the maximum number of students watch TV? What they are saying? For how many hours did maximum number of students, means most of them, watch for how many hours? How many students watched TV for less than 4 hours? How many of them they have watched the TV for less than 4 hours? And the third question is, how many students spent more than 5 hours in watching TV? How many of them they have spent more than 5 hours? Let us see the graph that is given to us. Here you can see on the x-axis it is hours of TV watched per day. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6 and 6 to 7. And on y-axis it is the frequency, the number of students. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32. And what are the frequencies now? Students who watch the TV for 1 to 2 hours, means it was less than 2 hours, 4 of them. 2 to 3 hours means less than 8 of them. 3 to 4, 22 of them. 4 to 5, 32 of them. 5 to 6, 8 of them. 6 to 7, 6 of them. These are the frequencies that are given. Now let us go to the questions once again. For how many hours did the maximum number of students watch TV? Now what is the maximum number of students? 32 is the maximum number of students, because 22 is less than 32. So the maximum is 32. So how much they watched the TV for? It was 4 to 5 hours, means it was less than 5 hours. How many hours? 4 to 5. Okay. How many students watch TV for less than 4 hours? Less than 4. Till here it will become less than 4 hours. 4 to less than 5, it will come here. So, how many of them they watch less than 4 hours? 22 plus 8, 30 plus 4, 34. So, 34 students watch the TV for less than 4 hours. How many students spent more than 5 hours in watching TV? What they are saying? More than 5 hours. Here 5 and above it goes. 8 and 6, 14. So, 14 students spent more than 5 hours in watching TV. So, these are the answers for question 5. By watching the histogram, by watching the graph which is representing the number of hours for which students of a particular class are watching the television during holidays. Please understand this, students, very important thing. These are not during school days, it is during holidays. Means we people also should note it, that only in the holidays we should watch the television, not on regular basis. And now the holidays are over, these are the days for our studies. So, we should watch the television only for our studies, not for any entertainment things. Are you understanding it? We shall proceed further now for the next concept, circle graph or pie chart. Now, what we are going to represent the data? We are going to represent the data in a circular form, which is known as circle graph or pie chart. You can see the figures here, two circular figures are here. The first one is telling the time spent by a child during a day. The time spent by a child during a day. It is in hours. Sleep is for 8 hours. Homework is for 4 hours. Other things is for 3 hours. Play is for 3 hours. And school is for 6 hours. A day, 24 hours a day, is been bifurcated, is been distributed in what? In sleep, homework, other work, play and school. And it is bifurcated, or it is distributed or divided in hours. Let us see the next example. Age of groups of people in a town. Age groups. I said age of groups, it is age groups. Age groups of people in a town. Now there is a town and they are finding out the data of the people based on their age groups, of what age between they are. 0 to 14 years, 30,000 people are there in that town. 15 to 60 years, 50,000. 60 years and above, 20,000. This is also the data that is represented in circular form. Let us see what exactly the explanation is there. These are called circle graphs. These are called circle graphs. A circle graph shows a relation between a whole and its part. Please understand carefully what is a circle graph. A circle graph shows the relationship between whom? a whole and its part. See, this is a whole day and the parts of the day are present here. This is a whole town and these are the parts of the town. On what basis the data of the town is been bifurcated or divided? It is on the age, number of years. So, 0 to 14, 15 to 60, 60 and above. This is the relationship that is been represented here. Further, they are explaining here the whole circle is divided into sectors. The size of each sector is proportional to the activity or information it represents. Yeah, they are telling something very important. What are the parts of the circle are made here? You can see here sleep, the part occupied here of the circle. Homework. You can see sleep has occupied a large part because it is 8 hours. Nobody else is of 8 hours, neither school is of 8 hours, neither play is of 8 hours, other work is not of 8 hours, neither homework is of 8 hours. So, the same they are telling here, the size of each sector is proportional to the activity or information it represents. Means randomly the circle is not divided into parts or into sectors. Actually, these are known as sectors. The circle is not divided randomly, but it is in a proportion. How the things are, let us see. For example, in the above graph, the proportion of the sector for hours spent in sleeping is equals to number of sleeping hours upon whole day. How many hours was sleeping is spent for sleeping? It is spent 8 hours. It is spent whole day is of 24 hours. 1/3 part of the circle. 8 ones are 8 threes are. So it is 1/3. So this sector is drawn as 1/3 part of the circle. Similarly, the proportion of the sector of hours spent in school. Number of school hours upon whole day, 6 upon 24 hours is equals to 1/4. Similarly, so this sector is drawn 1/4 of the circle. Similarly, the size of other sectors can be found. Add up the fractions for all the activities and do you get the total as 1? Yes, the total will be 24 hours. Here, if you see, the total will be 24 hours. Why? Because 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 3, 15. 15 and 3, 18. 18 plus 6, 24. And a whole day is completed. So, the same they are telling here that add up the fractions for all the activities. Do you get the total as 1? Yes, you will get it as 1, no doubt in that case. A circle graph is also called a pie chart. So, we have studied now what is pie chart or what is circle graph. We shall conclude the session here and in the next session, we shall continue with the same concept, with the same topic proceeding further. Till that time, you people take care of yourself and do your studies regularly. Thank you.